I left school at 16, left and got a job in a local factory. I soon became aware of how important the engineer's role was actually in industry. Production didn't run without the engineers. That's really when I first started considering maybe I could do something like that. I approached a company and asked them if I could undertake their higher electrical engineering apprenticeship. And they said yes, on the basis that you get a minimum of 5 GCSEs. So I went back to night school. I managed to gain 10 GCSEs actually at grade A. Only a year before that, I'd got grade E's and D's. There were too many judgments made about me not really being academic and really being a dropout. When I actually got that piece of paper to identify that I'd got the A's, I was just like gobsmacked. But it actually proved to me that if I wanted to put my mind to something, that I could really, really achieve that. The most exciting things really were understanding how things were, really understanding what electrical engineering was about, turning, milling, understanding how to use a lathe, for example. All those skills do support you moving forward as an engineer. Nothing would work without electricity. You couldn't even boil the kettle. It's such a critical industry. What I did enjoy about the apprenticeship, which I don't think is really promoted well, is that you do actually get fantastic academic qualifications. Throughout my apprenticeship, I got an HNC in electrical engineering. That gave me the footstep up to do a degree. Misconception that apprentices end up staying at the lower levels in an organisation. Well, I've rewrote the rules. I'm now in a senior management position within the National Grid. The National Grid basically picks up electricity from power stations. It moves it along the transmission lines, sends electricity down to the distribution companies. So without the National Grid, we wouldn't have electricity in the home. Every day in National Grid can be different. Currently, I'm looking at recruiting apprentices and engineering trainees for next year. But it is very enjoyable and it's really, really exciting. I hope that my story is inspiring, because if I hadn't have took engineering, then I wouldn't have had the success in my life. I'd really encourage people to consider a career in engineering.